guys, and welcome to this edition of the Honk Guy Channel. Well, it's Sunday afternoon, and here I am in the rig. You know, it's a nice sunny day out there, but still a bit chilly. However, not so much in here. It feels kind of nice. Oh, yeah, I got the stove hooked up. Check it out. Rocking in the free world. thank you, Justin, for the idea there, because I'll tell you what, that's a pretty good little unit right there. It does pretty good. And, you know, my biggest question is, why the hell don't they put these things in all RVs? Because really, it makes a whole lot of sense. Now, you guys know I've got a 28-foot RV. However, you know, I can shut off the bathroom here. But it doesn't make a difference. This little tiny heater heats up this whole rig. I'm just giving you an update after I've tested it out for quite a while. And I would have to say probably a really great investment, especially if you're just buying a used rig or something and not spending all those giant dollars for a new one. But yeah, it freaking works awesome, and I've got nothing but good to say about it. Is when I first fired it up, it had a really smell of burning, and that's because of the dust and various things that were inside of it. It took a little while to burn off that new smell, you know what I'm saying? But after that, no, the fear left, and the rig's still in one piece, and it's awesome. So I've got it hooked up to a 5-gallon propane tank down below in the storage compartment, and it's on a regulator. Got the hose running up through the bottom, and then hidden, you can't even tell it's hooked up to anything. And got my stainless steel little hearth, I call it, but it hides all the gas line and so forth underneath. It really works out great. It's not leaking and it's heating nicely. So if you guys got the extra $700, that's what they cost. I think it's a good investment. It does look nice. A nice little flickering going there. I did put a couple LED lights on the back side of it, so it has a glow to it on the back of it. Also works for a night light. And looks rather nice. And I'll take some pictures tonight. Got all the LEDs working throughout the rig. They're all on controllers. So it's 4 sections of bathroom, this middle section, the living room, and then the front driving area. They can all work together, or they can be syncopated or change colors in all those zones, or brightness, or whatever you want. So that's really cool, making some good progress on the upgrades, getting ready for the window run coming up here. My website's been updated even more since the last time I mentioned it. Go there, you can sign in the guest book now. I'd love to see you guys go to the website and sign in. And just lets me know people are visiting and who you guys are. And I'm trying to get a little mailing list together to give you guys some stuff in the future. So. Yeah, you just keep me in mind, you know, check out my website. I'm going to put it right about here somewhere. Check it out right there. And, go to it and, just say, yeah, you saw me on my channel and decided to click over to the website and sign my guest book. And that'll be cool. You'll be part of the whole, Hysteria City Window Run 2015 thing that's going on. Lots of cool stuff happening right here at the Honk Guy Channel in the rig with new heating systems just in time for summer. Perfect. Thank you, Justin. Just incredible. Thank you, Just Incredible, for giving me the idea there. This is the Honk Guy telling you like it is. That's a good stove. Buy one if you got the money. Put it in your RV. You'll save a lot of propane and a lot of power pushing the regular furnace. And this morning was very cold, but I fired it up and it warmed it up right in here real quick, maybe 15-20 minutes. Had the chill off, and then took it to a nice even temperature, and I've just left it on, and it really feels like it has dried it out in here. Even it feels like it's just a cozier space to be in, and I don't know if it's just the glow coming from it. It feels just drier and nicer and more cabin like I'm in the cabins in the woods, in a nice little cabin in the woods with bears outside and the nice fire inside. That's what it feels like. So, hey, rocket in the free world. Thank you, Justin. And don't forget, Justin, trek the earth. See ya, buddy. Just reminiscing on yesterday's events. We went to the RV show, my wife and I, and we checked out a bunch of new RVs. Really checked them out in depth. I didn't really get too much video of the checking out in depth stuff, but we really did check out all the new RVs, and there was quite a few of them. And man, the price tag is high for those things. And I'll tell you what, the new construction methods on those, a little bit shady to me. I don't know. They're really kind of cheesy, a lot of those RVs. There was just a couple of them that kind of piqued my interest, and I walked into one, and I was, oh man, this is cool, and I looked around, and it was another safari, but it was bigger than this one. It had a slide out as well, and so that one was pretty cool, but you know, the price tag on some of those new ones, just amazing. We saw some, you know, $300,000 just regular coaches, not buses. And then a rig like the one I have here, even not as cool. You know, you're looking up at the big bucks up there. You're getting up into, you know, 80, 90 grand. Unbelievable. I was just like blown away, even higher price than that. But low end, you know. So I suggest buying used. That's what I would say. And then just trick out your coach, because you can spend $5,000 and make your coach worth, you know, $20,000-$30,000, according to the guys at the RV dealership. Hey, hey, whoa, 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 hey, trying to do my thing here.
And that's cool. So I'm going to show you a little video of that right now. Christy and I walking around, I'll show you what I can.
And then at the end of this video, there's another type of RV that a gentleman out here in the Northwest is putting together that I'm very interested in. And I think that some of you guys out there that are into the whole stealth thing will be into these RVs big time. And in fact, I'm going to probably be talking with this guy, shooting some video for him, and making some very, very interesting new videos coming out on these new style RVs. You guys are going to trip. They're freaking awesome. So anyway, stay tuned. More coming from the hot guy right about now. All right, guys, so now here we are inside of a fifth wheel, kind of similar to what we have, but it seems smaller. I don't know. These things here seem to be getting cheaper and cheaper and cheaper as far as the quality and how they're put together. That's just my personal opinion, and looking at the woodwork, and since I do this kind of stuff, I understand how it's made and what's going on here. And wow, 50 grand for this thing. It's a fifth wheel, so. But it's got a slide out. And LED lights, so anyways, cool.
Rolling storage. You have to put groceries up here. That
good. Oh, that's where you put your CDs.
CDs,
you gotta put CDs up there. Oh, nobody uses CDs anymore. It's MP3.
There we go.
You got a pantry down there?
There's the grocery. Oh, nope.
And that's not much grocery storage.
Ew.
Not very much grocery storage. Still not seeing as much storage as the Trek.
No storage.
All right, guys. Here we are inside of another RV, and we're at the RV show here in Eugene. It is that time of the year. And we got Christy back there. Wave to him. She doesn't get on video very much. That's my lovely wife. She's checking out RVs with me. And right now we're inside of a coach that's similar to mine. It's about the same length, but this one has a slide out. And to tell you the truth,
it really doesn't seem any bigger than my rig. Actually, my rig seems like it has more space in it. The Trek is a wide body. I'm not sure if this one is, but just kind of comparing, you know, apples to oranges or something like that. But yeah, just pricing and checking things out. See, this is $77,000. That's probably about seven times what I paid for my rig. But anyways, it's a little bit smaller, not as well built.
No storage.
And absolutely no storage whatsoever.
Hardly.
To speak of. Not like the Trek. But anyways, we're going to go check out some more rigs. Stay tuned.